31-31 continues. Today we're talking about the St. Louis Blues. EJ Hradek joins me. EJ, won the Stanley Cup, and then last year they were very good in the regular season. They were the first in the Western Conference, and then they got to the playoffs, and frankly, they just ran into a team that was ready to win. They ran into a team that was ready to beat them in the Vancouver Canucks, and I was very impressed by with what Vancouver did. It wasn't necessarily what St. Louis didn't do, in my opinion. It was really what Vancouver was able to accomplish in that first round series. But it does lead you to some questions. You know, was the cup run, did they blow it all out in the cup run? And could they, you know, do you think if there was no pause in the season, would they have continued on and been a team that could defend that cup? Lots of different questions, I think, there for the Blues.
Yeah, you know, when I look back on that series with the Canucks, I would say two things. I mean, matchups and injuries always make a big – always important for me in the postseason. Like, that really tells the tale. And it wasn't a great matchup because the Vancouver Canucks have a real good speed team, and I think they could push the pace, and that helped. And I think there were some injury issues that probably hurt the St. Louis Blues. But at the end of the day, the biggest problem for the Blues was they just couldn't keep the puck out of their net in that series. And Jordan Binnington really struggled, so much so that they went to Jake Allen. They went back to Binnington at the end. He just didn't have it. And so they end up out of the postseason. So, you know, these are the things that happen. That is why it's very hard to win the Stanley Cup in back-to-back seasons. I'll be curious to see, you know, what happens moving forward with this team, because it was a very tumultuous offseason with the loss of their captain, Alex Pietrangelo, and the addition of Torrey Krug, who's a really good player, but he's a different player, certainly, than Pietrangelo. And can Jordan Binnington bounce back? And, you know, or was he a one-hit wonder? I mean, he was unbelievable in that season when they won the Stanley Cup. He was very good during the regular season last year, but he really struggled during the postseason. So with goaltenders, you're always wondering, you know, it's such a mental game. You know, you lose an edge somewhere along the way, and maybe you're not quite as good. So I think Binnington will be fine, but I do think it's worth watching next season, you know, how Jordan Binnington comes out of the gate.
Well, he won't look nervous, I don't think, right? I mean, he doesn't look nervous, right?
No, I
think Jordan Binnington is good. I think he's legit. I think he proved it, and he was good last year. I mean, he just didn't have a good run in that series against Vancouver, and that happens. But you mentioned a couple of huge changes for the Blues. Yeah. Pietrangelo is out. He's now signed with the Vegas Golden Knights, so they bring in Torrey Krug. But as you mentioned it, different defenseman. How does that impact the way that Craig Berube wants his team to play? Because Pietrangelo, to me, was that big but puck-moving, skating defenseman that could win the battles in the corner, play physical, but jump into the rush. Torrey Krug is much slighter, smaller, still goes into the corner and can come out with it, just a different type of player.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, when you think about having Pietrangelo, I mean, having Parayko on that right side, I mean, like, you own the left, you own the right side of the ice, you know, for most of the game. One of those two guys is on the ice. So for the left wings and the left defenseman on that side, I mean, who want to attack that way, it's really difficult to do that against St. Louis with those two guys. Now, one of them is gone, so that will change the dynamic of things. Torrey Krug is not as good a defender as Pietrangelo, but he is excellent on the power play, and he'll be somebody that could probably give a boost to that power play. So, you know, that's a plus. They still have, I think, a pretty meaty defense in St. Louis, but – let's be clear here. Alex Pietrangelo, big, strong, lanky guy, was just very, very difficult to play against. He was their captain. And so there is that matter of what kind of impact does his departure have on the team, if any. Hard to say. We're not in that locker room on a day-to-day basis. But certainly, I think if Doug Armstrong, the general manager there, could have figured this out financially, he would have. But I think when you go back, Dan, to when they went out and traded for Justin Faulk and then subsequently signed him, that sent a message that Doug Armstrong wasn't going to be held up in this situation. There was only X amount of money that he had to make to work with. And in the end, they couldn't find a deal, and Pietrangelo goes to the Vegas Golden Knights. So the Blues will have a different look. I don't think they'll be as nasty a group as they maybe have been in the past, but still a very good team and a very formidable opponent.
Yeah, I mean, you factor in Vince Dunn on the left side too, and Torrey Krug. So they go from being real meaty and big on the right side, and they still have Parayko there, to being maybe faster and more of a threat on the left side. So maybe that is the trade-off there that you'll see. And they may need it, right? Because my big question, and I'm talking, I jump up onto the left side, into the left wing. Yeah. What's up with Vladimir Tarasenko? I don't know what they can expect, if anything, from the guy who's been their leading scorer for years, because he's had three shoulder surgeries now, had another. He went back, played in the first round against Vancouver, couldn't do it, had to go back under the knife to get that shoulder operated on again. He only played 10 games last year, a couple in the playoffs. I don't know what to expect when a guy's had this much operation on his shoulder.
Yeah, that's pretty significant. You're right. I can remember talking to Jaromir Jagr years ago when he was with the Rangers, and he had came off shoulder surgery, and it was about halfway through the season, and he said, you know, my shoulder, I'm still trying to gain strength in that shoulder. So that's one of those injuries that it takes time. You can come back and play, but you're really not 100% strength-wise for a while. And so we will have to see what's going to happen in that circumstance. I mean, he's a highly compensated player for sure. If he can't play, you go on LTI, you save money, I guess, that way against the cap. But, you know, they need him in there. I mean, he, as you mentioned, he's a dynamic goal scorer. He's a big part of their offense when he's healthy. And I'm with you. I'm concerned because that's a lot of surgery on that shoulder. He needs time, and the Blues have a good enough team, Dan, that they can afford to give him that time.
Yeah.
So maybe it's one of these circumstances where even when we start the season, maybe he's not playing for a good while. I think they need to try to get him fully healthy before they try to launch him back into NHL games.
For a tank to be most effective, he needs all of its parts. Guy's
yes,
a tank.
Exactly.
And,
yes,
and he
exactly.
needs all of his parts working. Yes. But as you said, they are a good enough team. So I think they're still a playoff team, even with all these questions that we've asked. What do you think?
Yeah, I think so too. I'll be, you know, it looks like Ville Husso is going to be the second goalie there. Now, it's interesting because he was a guy that would have gotten that opportunity when they decided to move away from Jake Allen a little bit, but he was injured. Binnington was elevated. The rest, as they say, is history. So yeah. Binnington and Husso are your goalies this year. I do think this is a really good roster still. I do think they'll be a playoff team. But, you know, again, I'll be curious to see Binnington, especially early in the season, how he performs and if he's put a poor performance in the postseason behind him.
I just love the way they play, and I think Binnington is the real deal. So I say playoffs too. There's the St. Louis Blues.
All right.